Avery, how are you?
What's up, Avery?
What's up, fellas? Doing pretty good. How y'all doing?
Oh, we're great. We enjoyed the game immensely on Sunday. It was just wonderful.
Yeah, a lot of fun.
I mean, what do you want us to say? I will say this, okay? You continue to play your rear end off. And on a team where I don't know if everybody's doing that, it's certainly appreciated. I was a little upset with you with that face mask penalty, but it was inadvertent, but what are you going to do? But we had to bring it up. You know us, we're not going to let you get away with that without us saying something.
You know what I'm curious about with that?
But you are out there playing hard, and I can't say that for everybody, Avery.
I'm trying my best, man. I appreciate it.
That is true. When you reach in and grab Miles Gaskin's face mask, do you know it? Are you almost waiting for the flag, or is it something like in the heat of the moment, you don't even realize that that happened?
Oh, yeah, I already knew that I did it. Like, as soon as I grabbed, I felt it. And, it obviously wasn't intentional. But, just trying to get off a block. He's a short guy, so, I was trying to reach for his shoulder pad or something. And, having to reach out and grab his face mask. So, just one of the things I knew. I was hoping that the ref wouldn't see it.
Does that happen often, by the way? Like, does it happen often that you grab the dude's face mask and you get away with it? You know, official just didn't see it. Boom.
Yeah. I mean, I don't do it a lot. I mean, it happens. But the refs are pretty good at seeing stuff like that, to be honest. They got a good eye for it.
How about that, Joe? That's a compliment of the officials.
We love the officials. I'm a big fan of them. I can tell you.
Yeah, man. And they got good eyes.
Avery, not always. When Sam Darnold got body slammed to the ground, the play he got hurt on against Denver, I didn't see any roughing the passer penalty on that. But we'll let that slide. There were times, especially I think it was the first drive that they scored a touchdown on. That put them up 7-0 Miami, where it really looked like the defense looked like they could care less. It was so easy. I'm sitting there saying, what? I mean, how? Because the defense did play better in the second half. I mean, you guys played better in the second half. You got that pick by Brian Poole right before halftime. It could have been a lot worse. He held to, what, a field goal in the second half. Marcus May had that pick later. But, I mean, that first drive, man, it just looked like they walked down the field with ease on that, Avery.
Yeah, we didn't come out the gate. We didn't do a good job coming out the gate, and we talked about it on the sideline and we adjusted. We didn't play our best game in the first quarter, and second quarter we started to settle down, and Poole made that great interception before halftime, and that was huge because they were getting the ball coming out, so we knew we needed to not let him score before.
And I think you stopped them on three and out when they came out for the second half, too. Didn't they go three and out on that first series?
Yeah.
I think
they did. Went three and out. Right. Went three and out. So, every game, is not going to be, out the gate just, amazing. So, it's always, you never know what you're going to get. So, man, I mean, we fixed our problems on the sideline, and that's the main thing. We kept on fighting.
Does it get in your head that this offense stinks, that they're not going to give you any points, that as soon as you make a mistake or two and you guys are down 14-0, the game's over. You guys go pitch a shutout. This game, this offense can't do a damn thing. Does that ever get into the defense's head that you realize you got to carry this offense because it's putrid?
Man, we just got to make sure that we're doing our jobs. And, man, the offense is struggling, man. We just make sure that we're continuing to pick them up, uplift them, and hope that they do the same for us when we come off the field. But man, we just got to make sure that we're doing our job and coming to work every day, preparing, and go out there and just play the best defense that we can.
You know it's amazing, Avery. We talk about this all the time with the stats with the turnovers. This your defense. The last 3 weeks, the Jet offense has turned the ball over once, and you guys have taken the ball away, I think it's six times. And generally, when you are a plus turnover team, you're a winning team. This is what makes me – I mean, the Jets defy everything that there is about pro football. They really do. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely tough, man. you know, all we can do is just continue to create turnovers at the end of the day. That's all we can do. We just want to get the ball back to offense.
You need to score touchdowns. You need to get in the end zone with the defense is what you need to do.
Man, as many turnovers as we can get, man, we can generate points, you know, that's even better.
Now, one thing that happened this week is one of your bosses got in trouble with the other one of your bosses. Greg Williams made a comment about the defense, like, hey, it's not all about us. And he's got some truth to what he's saying.
Well, no question.
Adam Gase wasn't thrilled about that. As a member of that defense, what was your thoughts on Greg making those comments publicly?
I mean, honestly, I didn't even pay attention to that. I mean, I just kind of stay out of the way of that stuff. You know, I just try to make sure I stay focused on football and making plays. Because that's the only thing that I can control at this point.
You know, I want to go back to what you said. You know, we talked about that first drive, and you said, yeah, you know, you never know what you're going to get. We didn't come out right, or however you, I'm paraphrasing you a little bit here. Why is that? I mean, shouldn't you guys come out the first time out on that field? You guys are like smoking and ready to go. I mean, I don't understand that, Avery. How about that?
I mean, it's just, I mean, you know, never know how, I mean, this is how football is, you know. You look at any team across the league, you know, sometimes a team comes out flat, you know. We weren't playing like we should have been playing. And, you know, we got a good group on that side. So, you know, as leaders on the defense, you know, we talked and on the sideline, we corrected our problems and figured it out. But, I mean, sometimes it's how things happen. But the main thing is that we correct our mistakes and continue to play good ball.
We're talking to Avery Williamson of the Jets. How excited was Steve McClendon when he found out he was gone?
Oh, my God. He couldn't wait to get to Tampa, right? He just drove right there.
Yeah.
Man, I was shocked, man. I didn't expect that to happen, man. And, no, definitely him, you know, being the leader on his team, man, and been playing with him for, you know, for 3 years, man, definitely was it was tough to see him go. You know, I hate, you know, he's definitely a good friend of mine. So, you know, but it's, you just never know what can happen, you know, in this business. It's just a part of it, unfortunately.
But does that send a message? Like, look, Joe and I say, up, the season's going nowhere. You guys may go 0-16. I can't imagine you as players think that. You think, hey, man, we can win every game we play. Let's go win 5 in a row. I'm sure that's the mindset you have.
Definitely the mindset.
Right. As crazy as maybe Joe and I think that, that's absolutely the right mindset. When you see this happen, though, a veteran guy, a leader, like you just pointed out, get traded away for nothing. I mean, essentially, they got nothing back. They're just swapping a 6th and 7th round pick. Give me a break. What does that say to the locker room? What does that say to you? What does that say to the rest of the guys in that room?
Well, I mean, just, you know, it's just the nature of the business, you know, and anything can happen. So the main thing is that you got to make sure that you're on point at all times. And you know, anything can happen. Nothing, you know, nothing is promised, you know, in this business. So you got to make sure that you're on point, being professional, at all times, and just take advantage of the situation, just playing as hard as you can, you know, each week.
Are you worried that could be you, Avery? I mean, the trading deadline, I think, is what? What is it, Ev? A week, 2 weeks? What is it?
A couple of weeks, yeah. I think it's a week and a half.
Are you worried that, you know, you're going to play a game and walk into the locker room and they're going to say, oh, you know, we just traded you to, which would probably be good for you, I don't know, New Orleans or something like that? I mean, are you concerned that could be you?
I mean, I'm not concerned. I mean, it's, you know, at the end of the day, I'm just going to make sure I'm focusing on, you know, what I can do, and that's just playing football. And, you know, you can't control what decisions are made upstairs. So it's just some things are out of your hands. So it's just best to not even try to focus on them or worry about them.
By the way, the trade deadline is Election Day, November 3rd. So unfortunately, Election Day is the second biggest thing that day. It's actually the NFL trade deadline is number one.
That's an eventful day, that's for sure.
Do you
big day?
Have you talked, like, in all seriousness, have you talked to your agent and said, hey, you know, Get me somewhere else, man. Because, you know, you want to win. You don't want to be with this slop. Has that discussion and thought popped into your mind? Not that they could trade you. Of course they could. It's a business. You're right.
Right.
I mean,
right.
It is what it is. But has that come into your mind at all?
Nah, man. I mean, I just want to make sure I'm focusing on this plan, man. You know, just me getting back this year and just come back from this injury and, you know, finally getting my shot to, you know, to get out there, man, and make some noise and I mean, I don't want to focus on things that I can't control. So my main thing, man, is dude, just trying to come out every week and make the plays, man, trying to get a win, you know, help my teammates. So just there's no need to focus on the outside noise and just really just need to stay locked in on just trying to win some games.
Talking to our guy Avery Williamson of the Jets, they get ready to play the Bills on Sunday. Avery, I'm in a knockout pool with 15 people left, and I got two picks in it. Tell me why I should not take Buffalo next week.
Why you should not? Man, I'm hoping we're going to get our quarterback back, man.
Is Donald playing? I mean, is he coming back for this game? Do you know that?
I'm not sure, man, but, man, regardless, man, I know we're going to come out fired up. And we're going to come out fired up. We'll be ready to play.
You got to be ticked off, don't you? Is somebody in that locker room just, you know, going nuts about how bad it's been? And I'm talking about a play. I'm not even talking about the coaches. I'm talking about, you know, maybe you. I don't know. Somebody.
Well, I won't speak on, you know, what, you know, things that happened, you know, in the locker room. But, I mean, yeah, guys, we're definitely hungry for a win. And, you know, it's not like, you know, we're – everybody's just, you know, going about their business. You know, we're definitely upset. You know, we want to get a victory. You know, just as bad as everybody else, man. So, we're gonna come out Wednesday ready to go, practice hard, and shoot, just try to get a victory, man. We're gonna be prepared for it.
Do you hear, and the guys in the room hear the noise, that there is a large segment of Jet fans that don't want you to get that victory because they are eyeing a certain quarterback out of Clemson?
Yes.
That they prefer, even though they're Jet fans, they prefer you guys lose every single game because they're daydreaming of Trevor Lawrence being the quarterback of this team next year. Is that something you guys are aware of, that that's kind of a big thing amongst Jet fans?
I mean, honestly, I don't even pay attention to a lot of that stuff, man. But I mean, I'm sure some guy, I mean, I'm sure people hear it, but I mean, I don't pay attention to that stuff, man. Just cause it's just stuff that you know, we're not trying to lose, man. We want to win. We want to win games. But, I mean, I just try to make sure I'm staying locked in on what's going on, you know, with the team, you know, not the outside stuff.
Well, I'll give you some outside stuff you may like. That you're aware of. How about Kentucky over the weekend?
Man, that was good. What's his name? Pittman? Is that who's the who's the coach of Kentucky? Stoops is the coach.
Yeah.
Stoops. Pittman is with Arkansas. Stoops. That's right. He's done a good job there.
That's the first time they won in Tennessee since '86.
A long time ago. Yeah, I know. Like 17 straight losses there or something like that.
Yeah, man. So. I was excited, man. You know, I feel like they've definitely been doing a great job with that program and finally getting the right guys in there, you know, so definitely was excited to get that news. I couldn't watch it. I know that the quarterback threw two pick sixes in the first two drives. So I was like, man, I think we might actually win this one.
And I think they play Missouri. They got Missouri this week at Missouri, I believe, Kentucky. I want to say they play Missouri at Missouri, which is a game they can definitely win.
Yeah, they're definitely, man, they're doing a good job. I wish they would have got that Ole Miss victory. You know,
a tough one.
Yeah, that was a tough one, man. So it should be 3-1, but, man, you know, for not having any non-conference games, you know, it's gonna be a tough season. But I mean, I feel like they can definitely do some good stuff this year.
They do play at Missouri. I just looked at it.
Yep. At Missouri.
At Missouri, they're like a 6-point favorite on the road. So just to let you know that.
Be a good game.
Yeah, I it's funny because I really get into the SEC, and I love the fact that they're not playing any of these patsies. You know, none of that nonsense, which I hate.
Yeah, no warm-up games.
No, I mean, every game is a league game. I mean, it's good. I mean, that's the way it should be, to be very honest with you.
Yeah, no warm-up games. So they're getting smacked in the mouth every week.
He was only out there for 5 minutes, but any thoughts on Tua? Because now he's going to start. Dolphins announced that this morning.
Tua's going to start going forward now.
Yeah, I just saw that on my TV pop up on the screen. I was definitely, I mean, he's a good dude. I actually got to rehab with him quite a bit. down to Alabama this offseason. So definitely was glad to, you know, see him recovering well, man, and back on the field. But, man, he's a good young player, man, and, you know, definitely going to be excited to compete against him the next time we play Miami.
All right, so you got Buffalo this week. You lost to him opening day. You know, Josh Allen ran all over you guys in that game. And I don't know if you watched any of the game last night against the Chiefs, but, you know, look, their offense was no world beater. And the Chiefs' defense did a good job on them. Allen did not particularly throw the ball well, but, he ran the ball relatively effectively. How about this game now? I mean, they're coming off two straight losses, so you know they're going to be, they're going to be riled up. They're thinking they're coming in for a layup win against you guys. I mean, I would think that's the mindset there for the Bills. So how do you change it this week? Tell me, Avery. I mean, you guys got to come. You can't come out flat for this game, can you?
Nah, I can't. I mean, we can't come out flat. I mean, really, the biggest thing is just going back and looking what we messed up on, against them the first week. Definitely let the quarterback get out a few times. I mean, we created turnovers. Need to keep doing that. Definitely we just need to contain, just make sure that they're we're containing Josh Allen. They definitely are using him a lot more, running him. So and man, if we can make him one dimensional, just make him throw the ball and keeping him in the pocket, man, that would be huge, and get a couple turnovers on him.
Well, Avery, best of luck. Keep doing your best.
Keep swinging, Avery, man. We appreciate the Jet fans appreciates that you're out there busting it every week. Because, like I said, I don't know if everybody's doing that. You certainly are, no doubt.
I appreciate it. All right, fellas.
Thanks, Avery.
Avery, be well. Stay healthy.
Avery Williamson of the New York Jets looking for their first win of the year against the Buffalo Bills. If they don't get it against the Buffalo Bills, they'll try to get their first win of the year against the Kansas City Chiefs.
In Kansas City. Not that that matters, because it doesn't.
No, they can play that game on Mars. Right. It does not matter.
Right.